to present to you my two colleagues who are coming to speak on the progress that has been made in their various ministries in the last year. This program, which is the ministerial platform, is to begin a national conversation between those who have bestowed responsibility to work for the country at this level and the people of Nigeria. Governance is about involving people. Governance is about getting feedback from people. It is also about seeking their own wisdom to add to the wisdom of those of us that are in position of responsibility today. Nobody has all the answers, and that is why this program has been put forward. We are humble enough to admit that we are here by the grace of God and the favor of God, and that we cannot succeed unless we engage Nigerians, we get them also to understand that ministers are only leading in their ministries. The real work belongs to those who are working for the government, from messengers, family secretaries, and everyone that has the responsibility to offer service to the people of Nigeria. But up and above this, we do know that the democracy, the people are the leader. The people collectively are the leader, they are the sovereign. Our duty is to report back to them, because the mandate Mr. President exercises was really offered to him by Nigerian voters from all over the country. The President has therefore given us the go-ahead to begin this national conversation on the work in progress, because 1 year is not sufficient to make a conclusion on the activities of any government that has a 4-year mandate. But 1 year is long enough to begin to report the progress that is being made. And that is why we are here, to report to Nigeria the progress that has been made. In this last year, we have seen from the other ministries that quite significant work is going on in all the MDAs. And indeed, as we have seen when the National Planning Minister reported yesterday, Jean-Claude Osman, we also saw that this government is short-footed, because we have taken a portion of the time allotted to plan the development of the government and to plan every activity we want to undertake in the next 4 years, which is the transformation agenda that the President has unveiled. Now, a government that takes time to plan makes minimal mistakes. Because if you don't have a design, you don't have a compass and a destination, you cannot go on a successful journey. And so the President has planned, the transformation agenda has been unveiled, all the ministers know their mandate, they know the job that has been allotted to them, and we are implementing that. Everyone is implementing part of the agenda that their own MPs have been allotted. Today we are going to hear from the Minister of Housing. She is being a very seasoned technocrat, someone that got elevated in the public service to the highest level, the position of permanent secretary, and then to the height of that service, which is head of service. She has been a permanent secretary and head of service for many years. She has got a lot of experience on board. She's joined the Federal Executive Council. In council, obviously, she has all the tech, because she knows it from the technocratic part. She knows it as leader of the civil service before, and now as minister. She has done a lot of work in the Ministry of Housing. I don't want to be the one to tell you what she has done. I may comment on the things she has done at the end of our presentation, so that I don't take the wind off herself. But I know in the last year, she has brought momentum, she has brought vigor, she has brought leadership to the housing industry. And today, in both the states and at the federal level, a lot of houses are being built for Nigerians. Houses is the new housing policy, because often in government it is not the projects, it is the policies that bring about development. In the past, governance used to be about projects. Once you elected president or governor, they said, "I will build 2 houses, I will build the bridges," and there were no policies. We now know today that government alone never has the resources to satisfy the needs of any nation. So government is moving back into the modern balance of governance, which is that government must be a policy formulator in order to excite the kind of development you expect from the private sector. So housing is changing. Government isn't any longer the mass builder. It is those people who are in mortgage industry, who are in mortgage businesses that are now building houses. And what this ministry is doing today is to create an enabling environment, enabling laws, enabling policy to unleash the energy of private builders and developers. And we're seeing this in Abuja, we're seeing this in Lagos, we're seeing this in Port Harcourt, we're seeing this in many parts of the country. This is where housing should go. This is where housing should go. So, should be talking to you about the details of these plans and what to expect in the years ahead. But we also have today the Minister of Police Affairs, a soldier, a naval officer, an administrator, both during the military and now in the new civilian dispensation. Maybe Captain Obulade is a very disciplined person, not surprisingly, maybe his own career background. But government above this is a quiet worker. Both was in the ministry as a minister of special duties. So he was able to study what was happening in the government as a whole. And then later on, he became the minister of the FCC before he was elevated today as minister of police affairs. Now, in my short period of working with him, I have seen a man that would like results to go ahead of anything he would say. Today, the police, often are abused by citizens and people without sitting really down to evaluate the difficult job the police perform in any society. And I've also studied in different societies, not only in Nigeria, from America to Europe, everywhere. The police are not popular. Police are not popular because they are the face of the state, they enforce the law. And often, because of the freedom that we get in a democracy, we want that freedom unabridged. But the police must enforce the law in order that the freedom we get in a democracy will make sense. In Nigeria, we have faced a lot of security challenges. And because of this, I've had people often say, what can the police mean? What is happening? I tell you that the police are doing a lot. I'm not here to praise them. I know the police are working in a society that are going down. Where our values have crashed, and where crime, not just at any level, has become, you know, a pastime in many parts of the country. What the police have been doing is to do their best in very difficult circumstances. But I can assure you that with the challenges to face, this ministry is rising to the occasion. This ministry is rising to the occasion. With the new leadership in the police, and with the new leadership in the Ministry of Police Affairs, I want to tell Nigeria that a lot of background work is taking place. The security is our mutual responsibility. Security in any nation is the mutual responsibility of citizens as well as of security agencies. We all have our roles to play. Even behaving well is a lot of security side to the nation. And citizens will behave well and cooperate for us to attain our results. So I'll get going by calling on my colleagues to present what they have on what they are doing for the people of Nigeria. As he said, after that, we will not engage in a conversation with you. You will ask questions. You will give us your feelings. We will take this into so if you don't answer all the questions, there will be things we will take home in order to reshuffle our plans for the future. So I want to welcome all of us, and I wish all of us indeed a very, very fruitful and exciting conversation. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Honorable Minister of Information.